All right, moving ahead, now we have our first panel discussion over here, where we will be understanding the Indian consumer at a global level. And the topic for our first panel discussion is Understanding the Indian Consumer, a Global Opportunity, Smartphone Insights, Streaming and Consumption. I would now like to invite our moderator, Ruche Shukla, the Marketing Manager, Outdustry India. Let's hear it for him. Welcome. Please have a seat. Thank you. Now I would like to invite our panelists on stage. We have with us Mr. Manoj Damre, founder, VTO, Content Analytics and Intelligence. Yes, we have sir over here. Joining the panelists, we have Mr. Gautam Raj, founder and CEO, Hubhopper. Along with that, we have Tony Kakkar, an artist. And joining the panelists, we have Anita Nair, CEO, Havas Media Group, Southeast Asia. Welcome to all the panelists. Thank you so much.
Hello, check.
Yeah. Good morning, everyone. We have a fantastic panel today with us to kickstart with some big numbers that we've all been like hearing in the past 2 days, and we'll keep hearing today. We'll keep hearing forever. It is the most potential market that we are in right now. It's the most interesting times that we all agree. But welcome my panel on this lovely topic. My name is Ruche Shukla. I'm the marketing manager for Outdustry India, a unique music services company based in China, Taiwan, US, UK, and off last year, we are in India now. So just want to quickly have a brief introduction from your side of what you guys are doing very quickly. With Anita.
Ladies first, as always, yeah? Yeah, so my name is Anita Nair, and I look after the Indian Southeast Asian operations for Havas Media. Been in the industry long, 30 plus long years. Don't get into my age with those number of years. Good to be here. Good to be really checking this music forum out, because there aren't too many which are happening in the country. And I think there's a dire need, because as I said earlier, there is huge amount of talent in our country. And I think we need forums like these to really, really, you know, for them to come up. Thank you.
Tony, bye.
Hi, my name is Tony Kakkar. I am a musician. I make songs.
Hit
yeah,
songs.
That's what I'm trying.
Hey guys, I'm Gautam Anand. I run Hubhopper. Hubhopper is India's largest platform for podcasts. We have over 1 million hours of content across 15 languages and 8 demand and supply side products for the podcasting ecosystem.
Hi, good morning to everyone. My name is Manoj. We run a company called Vision, and it's into content, analytics, and insights. Let's call it like that, intelligence, as we say. It's based upon the fact that there is a lot of data and there is a lot of content. We just marry these together with a patented technology that we have applied for, and our attempt is to try and help the whole ecosystem and assist the ecosystem to understand where content flows are happening across platforms, across genres, across artists, and help them to make the whole thing even better.
Thank you, guys. Let's start with the biggest numbers that we have. 1.3 billion population, almost a billion plus users on smartphone are going to be reached by 2024. Subscriptions-wise, we are almost at 600 million plus over the last year, 2018, but then we are going to reach 1.25 billion by 2024 again. My question to you guys, and if Manoj, if you can open this panel here, are these big numbers a myth? What are these numbers that we should be realistically be talking about while having the consumers in our mind?
Wonderful, and I think it's a lovely segue, because Amarjit here in the previous session put out that quiz, 1500, 30, and 1. That one is interesting because the whole Balakadu Mantad Marathit, matlab the DNA of the whole number system is that what is that one thing that we are interested in? And when you look at how have these numbers come, 1.3 billion, sabko pata hai, meaning Mr. Modi has said that so many times that everybody knows it by heart. But is that 1.3 billion actually having 600 million handsets? Probably yes. And why? The simplest way is if there is anybody who has a smartphone over here, raise their hands. Almost everybody has raised. Is there anybody who has a feature phone here, raise their hands? Nobody. If somebody had raised their hand, I would have gifted you a smartphone. So you missed that opportunity. So here is the proof of the pudding, you know, very simply. People say that we are writing about big numbers, but you can see those big numbers by the naked eye. Aur kya chahiye iske andar? When you look at these kind of numbers, 50 million songs across the world and only 500,000 or 1 million that Amarjit was saying, probably that's the number that we want to bump up. And how has this number come? Is there is this troika. In Hindu mythology, they say, you know, B for Brahma, V for Vishnu, and M for Mahesh. In the classic new age mythology, it is B for broadband, it is V for virtualization, which means cloud, and M for mobility. When these three forces come together, you will see that the numbers automatically come. Once there is an advent of broadband, there is a huge percolation of people who are using it. Once there is a requirement that the mobility needs to be there, I want to use it when I travel from home to office and office to home and XYZ, you got it. And finally, what has happened is the cloud has happened. You know, I'm a technologist, so I have to say a little bit of things on that. Because the cloud has happened, distribution of content became easy. So when these Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh come together, broadband, virtualization, and mobility, you will get the perfect storm. So I am, for one, a complete supporter of these big numbers, and they are yet to happen in India in terms of usage, but they are pretty much there in terms of the basic fundamentals that are on. Everybody has a phone. Everybody listens to music. Everybody has two ears. Everybody has two eyes. Literally. What else do you want? So I think the numbers are real.
Fantastic, Manoj. We have. I'm never going to forget that motto, what you just said. It's a great hope for our the growing culture that we have. Gautam, very interestingly is that you realized this numbers 3 years back. And while your Hubhopper was a social networking site back in the days, but you could see where the podcast was heading. You could see where this audio streaming was heading back then. What was going on your mind back then?
So I think, and I completely agree with you because it's quite confusing. On a daily basis, we read a different number. KPMG takes out one figure, then EY takes out one figure. Then you see another application that's crossed 100 million mark. It's incredible to see. So whilst circling down on an exact figure is fairly difficult, there are a few undeniable facts, in my opinion. Undeniable fact number one is that smartphone adoption is happening at an unprecedented rate, unlike anywhere else in the world in history. Nobody can contest that. The second thing is that on average, people use their smartphone for entertainment. This is again nothing that one could contest. It's the truth. It is exactly what's happening. And the third thing, the thing that I find most special, which is what I saw 3 years ago as well, is that audio is special. Audio is unique. Why is audio unique? Audio is unique because of two major reasons. One is because of the fact that it actually addresses the opportunity cost of one's device. What I mean by that is everybody has their devices with them for approximately 14 hours a day. 5 hours of those 14 hours are spent on screen. 99% of your applications are trying to fight for some period of that 5 hour window. But audio has an ability to actually transcend from on-screen consumption to off-screen consumption. So instead of trying to fight for the exact same bloody time that everybody's trying to fight for, and churn is rising, and everybody's spending millions and millions of dollars, audio has the ability to actually capitalize on the 9 other hours that nobody's talking about. Actually look at that blue ocean window of opportunity and give people an experience that's unique and that's not as sort of shark infested. So that's scenario number one, that it has this ability to actually look at the 9 other hours in my day. But the second thing is that audio is not an either or form of content. it's an and form of content. So even when I am on screen, and I'm on those 5 hours of my day, and I'm using WhatsApp, I can still use audio. It supplements other experiences. When I'm driving, I can still listen to audio. When I'm getting ready, I can still listen to audio. So audio has the ability to marry different things that I was previously doing. So that's what I find very unique about audio, is that it's unlike any other medium. And for us to treat it like any other creature would be a disservice to the medium that it is. So that's my thought.
So I think that leads to my next question, is like, would you agree or disagree to the fact that people are mainly consuming data and content via music, and more than 50% are on YouTube and consuming the music in general as per via a visual medium. Do you think that is a competition for you in terms of an audio streaming, or how does it go?
So, I mean, super interesting. First of all, I think there's constantly this conversation about VOD versus audio. If you look anywhere in the world, these two aren't actually opposing entities. They both actually work together. Wherever there is video consumption as an explosion, audio consumption explodes as well. Because it's logical if you humanize it. People get used to consuming more in general. So they consume more actively when they can, and they consume more passively when they can. And I think the fact that you brought up YouTube is an incredible, example. Why? Is because a majority of India, and the YouTube office in India, actually, one of the largest queries that people have from YouTube is to let people play YouTube in the background. So you need to see our greed and hunger for an audio product that we're literally taking. I mean, it's so Indian of us. We're literally taking the world's largest video platform, and we're trying to use it as an audio platform. So we put on a YouTube video and then put it on the side and start to listen to it. We've all done it. I'm a culprit as well. And I wish as well, man, that YouTube wasn't eating as much of my battery, because I want to consume it in the background.
Fantastic. I'm sure everybody in the crowd is also doing back at their place. But Anita, from a brand side, how are you seeing these numbers, and how are you making sense of these numbers out of the behavioral patterns of the consumers? When you're pitching it to a brand, and when the brand comes to you, just in talking generally about music per se, what are you seeing in the consumers as their behavior?
So typically from a brand perspective, what are brands doing today? Like they're catering to audiences, right? And when you look at audiences, you bucket them, and you then look at the passion points of those audiences. And very often, and this absolute music to everybody's ears, is that music is one of the huge passion points, whether you pick up millennials today, or whether you pick up the older generation, or even you pick up teenagers, as in the sub-millennial guys. Music is music to ears for everybody, and a huge passion point. From a brand perspective, I don't think we've done justice, because we've not been able to marry what music brings to brands along with the way the brands should be using music. I mean, the classic case about Tony singing Coca-Cola too, right? Yeah. I don't know, within the given parameters, maybe Coke should have just lumped it up, yeah. I don't know why they didn't do it. If the stuff is really, to the core, meets all the rules and regulations of the brand, or the brand architecture within which the brand works, one could have easily lapped it up and would have been riding that, I don't know how many million views that he's got, or listenership that he's got on that. So I think it's the two industries, to my mind, while the audiences are there, we're talking about passion points. I think we're working in silos. I think there is a huge amount of scope for specifically audio industry, and I completely agree with you. I think what you said, Gautam, is again music to the ears of radio stations, because the audio consumption, we sit in metros and we are looking at only audio consumption. We're saying, okay, let me watch YouTube. By the way, I do a lot of that. I play YouTube in the background. Where I listen to audio, and there's a lot of audio consumption that happens in drive times also, because all the FM stations are doing exceptionally well. So I think there is a huge amount of scope for brands to marry those passion points with what is available in the music industry. There is the music industry opportunities, I think, are infinite, if you ask me. India is crazy. The talent in India is crazy. You pick up a talent at every nook and corner of this country. We should be able to marry those two and actually garner the data that we're talking about from an audience's number perspective, and specifically in the audio format, because it is not only the metros that we're talking about. Tier 2, tier 3, smartphones, for example, all hands up right here, none hands up in tier 2, tier 3, for example. You know, so there is a huge opportunity because it's voice. I mean, today we are happy saying, even if you look at the what we've transcended, we are happy to say, okay, Google and hello, Alexa, yeah? We're doing that all the time. You know, so I think voice has a huge amount of potential going forward. And within voice is, you know, what we are talking about audio. Within audio, we are talking about a lot of music. We need to marry them together. Just to quote an example, you know, we at Havas, Universal Music is brothers to us. And we actually created a music video called Thunder by Imagine Dragons to promote Dubai as a destination. So, you know, there is a lot that you can do. The HDFC Life example where Saruthake Jio, these guys have actually created an anthem with Arjun and Jyotika. You know, so the question here is that how do we marry the two? Because there is huge amount of potential. And I think we haven't hit it there, really.
So let's try making more sense of these numbers that you've been talking about. And Tony bhai, aapke liye question ye hai ki 16 saal ka Tony, क्या कंज्यूम कर रहा था म्यूजिक या एप्स में उस टाइम पे कंपेयर्ड टू 16 साल का राहुल या ऋतु जो एक टीयर 3 सिटी में है उस टाइम पे क्या कंज्यूम हो रहा था गेम्स में वेब सीरीज में म्यूजिक में और अब जाके क्या हो रहा है एंड आई अंडरस्टैंड कि आप ये सारी चीजें बहुत इंपॉर्टेंटली ट्रैक करते हैं तो आपका क्या कहना है
मेरा थोड़ा स्टोरी अलग रहा है कि मैं जो एक आम जो बच्चा होगा उसकी तरह कंज्यूम नहीं करता था मैं उन दिनों म्यूज़िक प्रोडक्शन सीख रहा था और ख़ुद से मेरे को कहीं से एक स्टूडियो से दीदी सोनू कक्कर वो स्टूडियोज़ में रिकॉर्डिंग को जाते थे और वहाँ से किसी से मैंने सॉफ्टवेयर लिया था पायरेटेड एंड उस सॉफ्टवेयर पे फिर मैंने काम करना शुरू किया और मैं बहुत सारा वक्त मेरा जो जा रहा था वो म्यूज़िक बनाने में जा रहा था उसको रिसर्च में जा रहा था क्या कैसे बेटर प्रोड्यूसर बन सकता हूँ मैं और ज़्यादा तो आई डोंट नो मुझे याद नहीं तब कुछ इतना भी था नहीं अभी इतना मतलब हम मूवीज़ वगैरह ही ज़्यादा देखते थे आई डोंट थिंक सावन आया आई मीन ये सब ऐप्स थे यूट्यूब था हाँ यूट्यूब तो काफ़ी टाइम से
अभी आप क्या देखते हैं स्पेशली आपके आपके जो फैन ऑडियंस में क्योंकि आपका गाना हर कोने में ट्रैवल कर रहा है सो व्हाट इज़ इट किस तरह से आपको हेल्प करता है आपके आर्टिस्टिक प्रोफाइल में
हाँ बहुत ज़्यादा बिकॉज ये जो स्पॉटिफाई और जितने भी स्ट्रीमिंग ऐप्स हैं इनकी वजह से गाना बहुत जल्दी पहुंच जाता है और अगर गाना में खुद में पावर है गाने में तो फिर गाना वो बहुत जगह इजीली पहुंच रहा है और अभी थैंकफुली सबसे कमाल की बात ये है कि अगर आप अच्छा गाना बना सकते हो और जो कि हिट हो सकता है तो फिर आपको प्रमोशनल बजट आपके लिए चाहिए ही नहीं आपको फिर आपके गाने में वो वायरल होने वाली पावर है तो फिर आप अपलोड कीजिए और फिर वो एक्सप्लोड हो जाएगा
फैंटास्टिक दैट साउंड्स लाइक अ सॉन्ग ऑफ योर एवरी आई मीन स्टोरी ऑफ एवरी सॉन्ग मनोज यू हैव बीन अ स्टॉवर्ड like you know a veteran in the telecom industry you've seen its shape in the last couple of years I want to bring this and touch upon this concept of the wallet share and mind share essentially where every user uses their extra bucks in a non-essential commodity I mean I remember my days when I was like you know a couple of years I'm talking 15 years back I would walk into a Planetum and Crossword and I'm like carrying like 100 bucks in my pocket but you know, when I get out, like it's like 4 CDs in my hand, you know. So that was where my money was, extra money was spent. What is the current trend right now? Where are the consumers spending or what are they keeping in mind while spending?
Brilliant. I think, you know, I think Gautam talked about share of audio. We take it one step higher and say share of ear. Okay. Are your ears open 24 hours? And there's a very famous, you know, one-liner that was used by Nick Reed, who's the CEO of Netflix. And he was asked by one of the audience in investor analysts saying that, who's your competition? He's saying, my competition is sleep. Okay, when people sleep, that's the only time when their eyes and ears are closed. Otherwise, completely I'm into them. You know, either I'm into them or somebody else into them. So to that extent, when you look at share of voice or share of ear, it becomes very interesting to see a day in the life of a consumer. So, subah utke, meaning if you even track what I do. I may not look like it, but I go to the gym in the morning. There is a song that I have that plays every day in the morning because the beats per minute are very high. So somebody told me, yaar, aise hoga toh bahut achha rahega, and then you can run faster on the treadmill. Not that it has had any impact, but yes, that starts like that. Fir dopahar mein aata hai, so I have to report back to my bosses and so on and so forth, let's say. So tabhi thoda thanda music aata hai. Uske baad mein dopahar mein at lunch, then you get to see saying that, yaar, what is my wife listening to? Or what is Gautam listening to in Delhi? So if I had something like that, I would start listening because discovery itna asaan nahi hota. Aapke jaise, meaning Tony Kakkar jaise bhai log kam hote ke explode ho jaye, let's say. But there are many long tails wale jo badhiya badhiya hai. Jitendra Abhishekhi, I don't know how many people have heard about him. But yeah, so that's something that is really close to my heart. If you try finding on Spotify, shayad nahi mile, aisa mujhe lagta hai. So that's that afternoon time when I want to get an input from somebody. Saying that Malik, ye chal raha hai. You know, fog chal raha hai type. What is happening? What is happening there? And then evening time is when I really get to relax. Wo piche gaadi driver chala raha hai. And that's the time when I start discovering stuff. That discovery time to me is something invaluable, which I think most of the marketers should target. If, let us say, I tell the marketers, abhi Spotify can give Spotify numbers, Gaana can give Gaana numbers, or a radio channel can give radio numbers, let's say. Is there anybody who can give it across? Saying that, listen, there is Tony Kakkar who is trending not only on radio, but also on Spotify, also on 93.5, also on 92.7 in Lucknow, in Kanpur, and in Rai Bareli. This kind of data, which is what my company does, by the way, so it's a little bit of a spiel, is what is needed to be made available. And, you know, to just give a testament to that, is when Tony told me that, arey yaar, ye data to humko chahiye, aapko kaise milega? So I said, boss, iska daam hai, thoda sa de doge to mil jayega. So that things has to come out. So who is consuming what is a Brahma Vakya mantat Marathit, saying that you have to know it. And you have to know it across platforms. Ke TV, video, audio, and remember Nick Reed's statement, my only competition is sleep. That is the only time when people don't really want to put your rapid eye moments and all that and monitor. But otherwise, I can guarantee you, once you start tracking as a marketer or a content creator or an artist or a distributor, a day in the life of an audience segment, that's the time when you start getting answers, ke interventions kaise hone chahiye. If I am going every day below that Mahim gantry, that gantry should have something that I want to see. If I am going every day and you know, doing my Navina on Wednesdays at St. Michael's Church, at that time, wo holding waha par aane chahiye. This is marketer, meaning I am preaching to the choir. Ma'am is sitting here with decades of experience. But I would urge every marketer sitting in this room, every artist sitting in this room, to try and map their audience's moments mentally and then play to that particular marketing spiel. That is what I would say. And of course, there is our software available.
Thanks, Manoj, for the wonderful insights. Circling back to the payment structures and how what a consumer spends, obviously the roadway to our current music scene has a lot of roadblocks. And to you, Gautam, I think you'd be dealing with this every day. How are the people actually paying, the people who are actually on the mobile data, how many people are actually paying for it? And I know that ad-supported models are right now just set, are like a stepping stone. And you know, they're laying the foundation for the paid and the premium models to come in. But how is this roadblock being tackled?
So just before I answer that question, I think I'm a slight outlier in this way because sleep couldn't compete with my love for audio. So I actually, I'm self-professed mildly crazy. I put flat speakers inside my pillow, or I wore headsets where I listened to content, because in 1 year I listened or read more books by listening to them than I had in the decades before by reading them actually. So it was so valuable for me that I can't sleep without audio content. So when I wear that headset, it's a very unsexy thing for a new wife that I've just had. But outside of that, my love for it is unparalleled. So I'm glad you brought that up. But you know, the point that you bring up is how are you going to tackle this issue of monetization? I think there's a larger macro problem at play. And that macro problem that's at play is the fact that we need to focus on localization. And localization across monetization, localization across experience, because localization doesn't just stop at the vernacular. Localization actually transcends that. Localization is actually sitting and being cognizant of the fact that your user here is a different entity altogether. And your creator here is also a completely different entity. This user may pay in a model that doesn't sit well with the way things work in the West. And it may not sit well with the way things work in the East. India is a very unique territory in that way. So the way that I think that we should look at this is that India already has all the raw materials. Everything that is required for audio content to work in India already exists. High commuting times were second highest in the world. High amount of time spent at home were second highest in the world. High amount of multilingual, multicultural ethnicities that stay in one location, well, nobody beats us in that. Data cognizant, being cognizant about the amount of data that we're consuming, fantastic at that. Low barriers of creation in audio across languages. The fact that publisher-generated content in audio is less capital-intensive and is also not literacy-intensive is incredible. But the thing is, we just need to sit from the perspective of the user and say, listen, how would this user pay? Maybe the sub-model doesn't work as well here. Maybe bundling it with a telco would work here. Or maybe from the creator's perspective, if you actually sit in the life of a creator today, I mean, the way that Tony was mentioning, the fact is that today we've almost made it impossible for a creator to be able to create. It's almost like we don't want them to do it. If you look at the Indian podcaster today, from them to have the intent to start creating a podcast, to actually getting to somebody's ear is an impossibility. We need them to be technical experts. They first need to know where to host, what hosting is. Then they need to know where to record, which is happening on some other platform. Then they need to know where to edit. They open this incredibly crazy tool called Audacity, which just looks like a spaceship. Yeah. After Audacity, then they need to figure out what an RSS is. These guys aren't technical, but they need to do this. We expect them to do this. Then they have to go and take that RSS and put it in different platforms. And then somehow, just like Manoj sir said, they have to figure out how to analyze that data and then figure out how to monetize over it. So then post that point, if we actually expect creators to just come in without us technologically making these barriers easy, is impossible. I mean, essentially the biggest thing that I think we should solve right now coming together, and I love the fact that this event is happening, is that people need to come together and figure out how the hell can we make it such that the 500 Tonys that want to start creating a podcast or creating music don't have to go through this laborious 5-year process of creating and then distributing, because for every 5,000 Tonys, there's only one that is, I mean, fortunate enough to be actually exploding in the way that you are, which is a travesty because the greed is for Indian content. So, I mean, that...
Excellent. I think you've just led me to the next question. Let's listen from the main man himself, Tony Bhai. What is the sound of the millennial?
Since always it has been the same, जो उसका कोर है जो सोल है वो सेम रहा है और कभी भी जो जितने कैची सॉन्ग्स पहले आते थे उतने ही अभी कैची आते हैं आई फील बस उसका साउंड थोड़ा चेंज हुआ है आप देखें कि गाने जो नहीं आजकल के चलते हैं उसमें मेरे को लगता है कि सिर्फ प्रोडक्शन ठीक हो जाता है और फिर जो उसका सोल जो इंटैक्ट रखना चाहिए उनको जो कि गाना जैसा टेक्निकली होना चाहिए वैसा हो नहीं पाता है तभी वो गाने वर्क नहीं करते मुझे लगता है कि अगर हम जो हमारा इंडियन सोल है जैसे हम जिस जो हमारे जीन्स में है जो म्यूज़िक सुनने जिससे हमें मज़ा आता है जो हमारे पापा मम्मी को पसंद है वो तो हम बनाना छोड़ रहे हैं तो वो बनाना छोड़ेंगे तो गलतियाँ होगा गाना आप कॉम्पोजिशन लिरिकली आप ओरिजिनली जैसे हम हिंदुस्तानी हैं वैसा रखिए प्रोडक्शन आप इंटरनेशनल करता जाइए I feel wo hona chahiye.
Fantastic. I love that, what you said. I think we have just a couple of minutes left, last 3 minutes. Anita, just want to bring back, in terms of brands, we've talked about numbers, we've talked about the trends. How can a brand leverage the content? And how can they actually reach to the right target audience? You give an example of Coca-Cola too. Technically, Coca-Cola should have jumped on the track right from day one. But maybe it was a missed opportunity. What do you have to say?
Loads of such opportunities missed, actually speaking. And the reason that I see is that I think as an industry, we work in silos. Tony is going and creating his own song, which is doing the charts. Neha's doing something, Sonu's doing something. But I don't think, I think the first thing should come from brands to try and leverage that is existing in the marketplace. You know, I don't think brands are really opening their minds as much to leverage the opportunity that is lying in the marketplace. You've got content here, you've got data there. Yeah, all you have to do is marry that and you can just create wonders there. It's a question of creating something and force fitting, or it's also a question of actually seeing what you want and then creating it. For example, when you were mentioning that there is so much that one needs to do, right? A day in the journey. I mean, it's as simple as trying to figure out what is it that your consumer likes, right? And if you know what your consumer likes or what is it that ticks the consumer, then you would do that. Now, what ticks you in the morning to increase your speed on the treadmill vis-a-vis what ticks you in the evening with a drink in your hand are two very different things. And I think we are just not able to, you know, make good use of that. So to my mind, I think there's a lot of synergy that is required for the two industries. And since this is a music forum, specifically talking about music, I think there is a lot that can be done and that will break the charts like his songs do. For me, soul of the music, as he said, rightfully said, I don't understand the tals and the rags and whatever. But to me, music is what touches here, what gives me goosebumps and which brings tears to my eyes. You know, so that is what soulful music is all about. And that is what if you're going to do to your consumers as a brand, you've had it. I mean, you've made it. You know, your conversions will be there, loyalties will be there, trust will be there. And that connect and engagement from your heart with the brand will be there. So I think there's a lot needed to be done in that area for sure.
Yeah, we'll come to the questions just in a minute. I think very importantly here, we are all from like a different variety of streams here, and it's very important to kind of collaborate and have that synergy, as you rightly say, ma'am. So I guess that's the future. And just talking about tapping on the future of the consumers, I want each one of you to answer just in a simple liner. What are you most excited about? I think 5G is going to roll in a couple of months or years. More and more visual content and audio content is being going to consumed in the most innovative way, with AI doing its thing, with the 360-degree viewing coming in. What are you most excited about for the Indian consumers?
You know, from the availability of data and content, like what we have heard, I think we have done very well so far by monetizing consumption. So, kitna deti hai? You know, that's the question. Kitna hoye million hits, Tony Bhai? You know, that's the quantified question. I am proposing that we should monetize fandom. Ke aapke kitne fans hai? And it's not just likes. It's about what is the total duration of songs that were played under Tony's banner, let's say. Is it in million minutes or zillion minutes? So that gives engagement. And therefore, if your songs are going to be soulful or if your content is going to be soulful, automatically it will be registered in the mind of the consumer and he or she will keep on hearing it, let's say. So it is not the number of plays. Of course, it's a great metric and important metric. It's like GDP, right? Everyone wants GDP, but nobody knows the next step of GDP. So therefore, I would say, let's move from monetization of consumption, which we have done well because thousands of metrics are there, to monetization of fandom. Ek bande ne kitne baar gana suna dala tha, 95,468 minutes or something like that. I can give you that data every day. And once you know that, you will automatically find a way saying that, wow, at that 5,000 minute kind of barrier, you hit the records. That is your escape velocity. So I would say go from consumption to fandom. And that's the monetization sequel.
So I think what excites me most is the ending of isolation, and the ending of isolation in three fronts. Let's take from first looking at the terminology itself, and I'm obviously going to speak from my perspective. I want the word podcast, and I'm saying this in a public forum, I want it to die a horrific, horrific death, because it is such isolating, misleading nomenclature. Nobody associates podcast with Premchand ki kahani. Nobody associates podcast with Kabir ke dohe or with the Granth Sahib or the Quran or the Bhagavad Gita that their grandparents used to listen to. Once that ends, that's something that I'm super excited about, because that stops the isolation that currently exists, that people believe that only like Mastery Lessons by Robin Sharma is what a podcast is. So that's isolation on one front on terminology. Second is isolation of user. Here is where I see the biggest irony. There's a dichotomy that exists. You're taking a medium that is inherently not discriminatory on language, not discriminatory on literacy. But then we package it into a product that requires people to be literate and requires people to know a particular language. It's the biggest irony ever. So the way that ma'am said that we need to start, you know, viewing, disseminating this content to people in a way that they can actually consume it, something I'm super excited about. That's isolation number two. And the third and the most important one is opening the door for the creator. And I will work till my bone to make sure that, you know, a creator can come to a platform, and this is what we do. A creator can come to a platform, not worry about hosting. They can host. They can create multiple pieces of content, music or non-music. They can submit that to multiple platforms. In 1 second, they'll be in Ola. In 1 second, they'll be in Alexa. They'll be in Samsung. They shouldn't need to worry about that. And then they'll get analytics and figure out monetization from one platform. That's the third isolation that I want to end. That's it. So that's what I'm excited
thanks
about.
Thanks, Gautam. I think I'm going to use the term podcast very carefully. And so thanks for the info. Tony Bhai, what are you excited about? The new age consumers, new fans.
I'm really happy that everything is now monetized. Like, music is monetized in a better way. And as a musician, अगर ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोग ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा musicians अपना music monetize कर पाएंगे और वो पैसा अगर directly उन पे आएगा तो better music होगा, musicians brave होंगे, musicians ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा, अभी तो सारी कहानी उल्टी पुल्टी है, किसी को पता ही नहीं है पैसा कहाँ से generate होता है, कहाँ आता है, आता भी है, नहीं आता है, अब टोनी कक्कर के गाने ने कितना पैसा बनाया कभी पता ही नहीं चलेगा, और जब वो ही चला जाएगा, वो मर जाएगा, तब पता, अरे वो पैसा तो, वो गाना तो 200 करोड़ रुपए बना के गया और टोनी का शायद 2 करोड़ भी ना मिले. तो मेरा सिर्फ ये कहने का मतलब है कि अगर जितने अच्छे ट्रांसपेरेंट हो जाएंगे, तो मेरे से तो बहुत अच्छे अच्छे म्यूजिशियंस पड़े हुए हैं, वो बाहर आएंगे, उनके उनका म्यूज़िक रिलीज होगा. शायद मैं लकी हूँ या हम जितने भी लोग इंडस्ट्री में काम कर रहे हैं, जितने भी सब लकी हैं, इनको थोड़ा सा पता चल गया है कि चीज़ें कैसे आगे लाई जा सकती हैं, कैसे रिलीज़ की जा सकती हैं, कैसे उनसे. अब देखें, बड़ा मुश्किल हो जाता है एक गाना आप रिलीज़ करो. माना कोका कोला मैंने रिलीज़ किया, अब उसके बाद अगर वो अच्छे से, मेरा सेटअप अच्छा नहीं है, तो मैं दूसरा गाना रिलीज़ ही नहीं कर सकता, क्योंकि मेरे पास वीडियो बनाने का पैसा नहीं है. क्योंकि जनता तो वही एक्सपेक्ट कर रही है कि वही वो LA में शूट करेगा, बड़ी कार से उतर के आएगा, यू नो, वो पॉसिबल नहीं हो पाएगा. तो इसके लिए जो मेरा पहला गाना है वो अच्छे से मोनेटाइज हो, मुझे अच्छे से उसका पैसा मिले, और फिर म्यूज़िक में ही इतना पैसा है कि म्यूज़िक से ही सब कुछ किया जा सकता है, पर वो पता ही नहीं चल पाता है लोगों को, बड़ी मिस्ट्री है. आई कैन नॉट टॉक इन डिटेल, एंड जितना मैं बोल सकता था मैं बोला. सो थैंक यू
अनीता जस्ट.
या सो आई एम सुपर एक्साइटेड अबाउट एवरीथिंग दैट दिस थ्री आर एक्साइटेड अबाउट. या सो टू कट द लॉन्ग स्टोरी शॉर्ट, बट आई थिंक इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस टू मेक दोज कनेक्शंस in the right context with the right content. I would just sum it up by saying this, and that takes care of, from a content context perspective, your money is your monetization, from a content perspective, what you're singing, and of course, when you're making those connections, you're home. So that's my two bits on this.
Fantastic. Do we have a time for a couple of questions, one or two questions? I guess, I think we can take one question here.